everybody told us we were crazy, told us it couldn't be done. Couldn't be done at 1550, couldn't be done in the iSafe region, couldn't be done economically. Everybody told us you couldn't do what we've proven can be done. And I'm at Luminar because we're continuing to amaze with the technology that we're able to develop with the team that we've assembled. Delivering LiDAR technology to the automotive market to unlock autonomy is hard. And if you have to sacrifice performance based on what's available commercially, you're not gonna get there. We recognized very early on that it was critical that we took our own destiny in our hands and we developed the technology from the chip level up to unlock the performance we knew was possible. We quickly realized that vertical integration would further accelerate our innovation processes. We have one by one acquired the best in class companies behind the three key LiDAR hardware components, the receiver technology, the ASIC, and the laser. All the magic is done inside the Black Forest Engineering Design ASIC. We acquired Black Forest Engineering back in 2017. Here at BFE in Colorado Springs, we invent and design the custom ROICs and signal processing chips, or ASICs, inside our Iris sensor. The most important thing is obviously the economies of scale that come from that little chip. But the performance that you get by integrating everything is not possible without the chip level integration that we do. Optigration makes the world's best photo detectors. We acquired Optigration last year and just outside of Boston. We develop and manufacture in-gas photo detector chips. They deliver unprecedented dynamic range and sensitivity. And this year we acquired Freedom Photonics. The laser technology that's coming out of Freedom Photonics not only is unlocking the economies of scale, but has enabled the next generation or two or three coming out of Luminar. We have the world's cutting edge performance, both in beam quality and in power, directly from a laser diode. There is amazing synergy that occurs when these components come together inside our LiDAR systems. We've spent years optimizing our receiver modules and LiDAR transceivers right here in Orlando. Now it's about taking the processes that we've invented here in Orlando and transferring it over to Fabrinet, where they take that core technology and designs and processes and scale it up for series production.
We're here today at Fabrinet in Bangkok, Thailand, to work with them to consolidate the gains that we've made in improvements and to review with them where we're going next. So as Luminar was looking for partners to be able to scale our product to automotive volumes and automotive quality, we needed some partners to be able to do some key assemblies for us. And in particular, the core laser transceiver. We picked Fabrinet after looking at a lot of options, primarily because they have a unusual combination of experience with optics, experience with automotive markets, and high volume manufacturing. A lot of our components are quite complex, and probably the most complex component with the most challenging assembly is the laser transceiver. We're essentially trying to line up our laser on a very small dot, these APDs, at a range of 500 meters. So in order to do that, we have a fairly complex station here that looks at the receiver, looks at where the lasers are lined, lines them both up in six axes, and then adjusts that alignment such that we are achieving the alignment that we want. The relationship has been quite fluid as we've learned and rolled lessons learned from our cycles of learning into the product. In the last quarter, we've done a lot of work together to do process tuning, process improvements that have made dramatic impacts on our yield and our throughput. Moving forward, we'll continue to dive into PFMEAs and FMEAs to improve our testing, to improve our process inspection, and then to add automation and to add capacity to be able to get to series production by the end of the year.